Hello and welcome to another lecture on vectors. Today we shall be discussing about the vector product of given vectors. Now this vector product is also known as the cross product. Later we are going to deal up with some properties of vector products. And finally we should conclude this lecture based on vectors by discussing some numerical problems on vector products and their properties. So now starting with the basic definition of a vector or cross product of two vectors. The vector product of two given vectors, let's say vector A and B, as denoted by these two axes, let's say this is vector A and this is vector B. Now the vector product, which is also known as the cross product of two given vectors, is given as A into B, which is equal to AB sine theta, where theta represents the angle that is formed between these two vectors whose cross product is to be found. And also here A is equal to mod of vector A and B is equal to mod of vector B. And the direction of the vector product of these two given vectors is perpendicular to both A and B. That means this represents the direction of the vector which is equal to the cross product of two given vectors, that is A and B here. Now the vector product of vector A and vector B is denoted by A vector into B vector, which is equal to mod of vector A into mod of vector B into sine theta, and this is multiplied by n, where n is a unit vector perpendicular to both A and B, such that A, B and N form a right-handed triad of vectors. Thus, the unit vector which is perpendicular to A and B and is represented as N cap is equal to the cross product of vector A and B, and this divided by AB sine theta. That is, N cap is equal to the cross product of vector A and B, and this is divided by the mod of the cross product of A and B. Thus we have found the value of cross product of vector A and B as A B sine theta into N cap, where N cap represent a vector which is perpendicular to both A and B. Now here we note that if A and B are parallel to each other, then theta is equal to 0. That implies the cross product of two given vectors is equal to 0. Similarly, if any of the vector is equal to 0, then automatically the vector product is equal to 0. Next, we are going to discuss the properties of the vector product. The first property is the non-cumulative property. That is, the vector product is non-cumulative. And thus, the cross product of vector B and A is not equal to the cross product of vector A and B. Next property states that the vector product of a vector A with itself is a null vector. That means the vector product of A vector by itself is equal to a null matrix. By the fact that here sine theta involved is equal to sine 0, therefore the cross product is equal to 0. The third property states that the vector product is associative with respect to a scalar. That is, M into the cross product of vector A and B is equal to M into vector A into vector B, which is equal to the cross product of vector A and the product of scalar M and vector B. Now here, as we can make out that this M represents a scalar quantity and the two vectors are A and B. Next we have the distributive property. Now for any three vectors, let's say A, B and C, the distributive law states that the cross product of vector A by the cross product of vector B and C is equal to the sum of the vector product of vectors A and B and vector A and C. Next we are going to discuss the results of vector products. Now we have already discussed that the vector product is given as A into B, which is equal to AB sine theta multiplied by the unit vector n, which is perpendicular to both A and B. Now we have, based on this expression, the first result as the vector product of two parallel or collinear vectors is zero. That means if two vectors are parallel or collinear, then theta is equal to 0 or 180 degree, which implies that sine theta is equal to 0, and therefore we have the cross product of vector A and B equal to 0. Second, we are going to discuss the vector product of perpendicular vectors. Now for perpendicular vectors, we have theta equal to 90 degree, which implies that sine theta is equal to sine 90, and therefore sine theta is equal to 1. That means the cross product of vector A and B is equal to AB into unit vector, which is n, or we can say that this is equal to AB. Next we have the vector product for parallel vectors. Now for parallel vectors, theta would be equal to 0, which implies that sine theta would be having a value of 0, and therefore the cross product of A and B is equal to 0. Next we are going to consider the vector product of two unit vectors. Now here, if vector A and vector B are unit vectors, then mod of vector A is equal to mod of vector B, which is equal to 1. And therefore, by the equation that we have discussed in this lecture, the cross product of A and B is equal to sine theta into unit vector n. Next we are going to consider the vector product of unit vectors I, j and k. Now here let us consider I, j and k be the orthogonal triad of unit vectors, then I into j is equal to, since these are unit vectors, we have their magnitudes as 1, into sine 90, since these are perpendicular to each other, multiplied by the unit vector n, which is perpendicular to both I and j, and thus we can write n equal to k. And thus we have the cross product of I and j equal to 1 into k, which is thus equal to vector k. Similarly, we can find the vector product of j into And now since these two vectors are also unit vectors, therefore we have their magnitude as 1 into sine 90 multiplied by the unit vector, which is perpendicular to both of these unit vectors, which is equal to I. Therefore, this would be equal to I vector, and the cross product of vector k and vector I is equal to the unit vector j by use of the similar facts. We also note that the cross product of two similar unit vectors would be equal to 0 since they form an angle of 0. Therefore, the cross product of I with I is equal to 0. Similarly, the cross product of j vector with itself is equal to 0, and the cross product of unit vector k with itself is also equal to 0. Next, we are going to find the vector product in terms of its component. For this, we consider vector A and B being specified in terms of unit vectors I, j and k as vector A equal to A1i plus A2j plus A3k. Similarly, vector B is represented as B1i plus B2j plus B3k. Now, in order to evaluate the cross product of these two vectors, we have the method in which we can evaluate the cross product as the determinant value of the determinant whose first row consists of I, j and k, second row consists of the elements of A, that means A1, A2, A3, and third row consists of the corresponding elements of B, that means B1, B2 and B3. Thus, we have the cross product of A and B equal to the determinant in which the elements of first row are I, j and k unit vectors. The elements of second row are the components of the first vector, that means A, and the elements of the third row are the components of the second vector, that means B. Next, we are going to discuss certain problems. Here we have a problem in which we are required to find the sine of the angle between two given vectors. Now, as we have earlier discussed, that sine theta depends on the cross product of these two vectors. Now, here let's label the first vector as vector A and the second vector as vector B. Thus, we have vector A as I plus 3j plus 2k and vector B equal to 2i minus 4j plus k. Now, as we have discussed in this lecture, that the value of sine theta is dependent upon the cross product of these two vectors, which are labeled as A and B here. Thus, we have the sine theta value as mod of cross product of A and B divided by the individual mod of vector A and B. Thus, in order to evaluate the value of sine theta, first we need to evaluate the value of cross product of vector A and B. Now, as we have discussed earlier, we are going to use the vector product in terms of its component. And thus, we have the cross product as the determinant of the determinant whose first row consists of the unit vectors I, j and k. The second row consists of the elements of the first vector, that means 1, 3 and 2. And the third row consists of the elements of the second vector, that means 2, minus 4 and 1. Thus, we have the value as I into 3 plus 8 minus j into 1 minus 4 plus k into minus 4 minus 6, and thus we have the value as 11i plus 3j and minus 10k. Thus we have the mod of the cross product of vectors a and b as root of 11 square plus 3 square plus minus 10 square, which is equal to root of 230. Next, we are going to evaluate the value of mod of vector a and mod of vector b. So now, starting with the value of mod of vector a, which is equal to root of 1 square plus 3 square plus 2 square, which is equal to root of 14. Similarly, we can evaluate the value of mod of b, which is equal to root of 2 square plus minus 4 square plus 1 square. This is equal to root of 21. Thus, by the use of the formula specified by this equation number a, we have sine theta equal to root of 230 divided by the product of root of 14 and root of 21, which can be rewritten as root of 115 divided by 147. Thus, we have evaluated the value of the sine of angle between these two given vectors. With this, we conclude this lecture on vectors, which was based on the vector product of two given vectors.